Hey guys, and welcome back to Thornton Farm. Now then, in today's episode, we were going to be mowing at the castle, but they changed their mind, and they no longer want it mowing, they want to let the farmer do it. It's a bit disappointing there. However, National Trust have got back in touch with us, and they would like their wildflower garden mowing. So they've got a property on the other side of the map here that they would like mowing. Now, before I get into this video properly, 1,000 subscribers, we're almost there, we may have even hit it by now. What would you guys like to see as a sort of special video for that? Because I have had a few ideas. Maybe a live stream of some form, but my internet, I don't know if it'd be able to handle live stream and stuff like that. Oops, forgot to lock the mowers on. So yeah, would you guys like to see some form of like special video? So maybe like an hour long Thornton Farm or Knave's Well or something. Take a while to upload, but yeah, it would be a different form of video. So what we're going to do first is we'll drive up to the landscapers area. I've been told that we have to go up here, and we're not allowed to take this pickup truck onto the grounds. We've got to use their vehicle, as it's permitted to drive around there. So see, it's already here. If we back in possibly, so we've got to get that trailer possibly on, maybe we'll take it up to the main area. But this is their gardens. Now, if you guys wanting to find this on the map, it isn't on it. I have added this into the map myself. I spent an hour or so just adding in a whole lot, just so it can, I don't know, add a new feature to the game, really. So what we want to do is we want to attach this onto the trailer. I'm not sure if this will be able to tow it properly, but I can always give it a go. There, what's going on with that? I think that's something to do with collisions, possibly. For example, once I take that off, it's fine. Right. If we leave that flatbed sort of thing here, they said that we can basically use this. We are the only ones that use this, apart from the staff. For example, if there's a lost child or something, they drive around in this to try and find the parents. That's all they really use it for. One thing they did stress was that we shut this gate just in case anyone thought they can get free entrance to the park here. Well, I'd like to call it a park, to the gardens, let's say. But there is a house up at the top, and yeah, it's quite a nice area. Haven't done this before. I added this in about 15 minutes before. I added this version of the map in 15 minutes before this episode, so yeah, wouldn't have seen it before. We've got to drive at 5 mile an hour around the property with beacons and hazards on. But what they said we can do is we can drive onto that path there, or we can go onto the grass slightly if we needed to. This is the house that they've got here, nice large house. Incredibly realistic path height there. So yeah, I'm not entirely sure where it could go. So we've got to mow all of this. So I didn't bring the little push mower, although some of you guys would have wanted to have seen that being used. I did use it in last episode, so I thought I can give it a miss for today. It's a very big property, this. So what we'll do, unfold the trailer here, unlock the load, and we've got to ensure that we apply the kill switch on there, just because if we don't, then people will think we can drive around in this. So yeah, just to ensure that it doesn't get stolen or joyridden around here. So, mouse seems to have died again. Batteries are rubbish. Right, hopefully that lasts the rest of this episode. We'll do this main large area first. So we'll get off the path. And then in the other area around there, we will be using the stand-on to do that part. I did also change the cut grass texture. I didn't quite like that green, no, sorry, the yellow. So make it look a bit nicer. I've gone for this green. I found it on FS UK, so if you guys want to do that, I think there's a guide that comes with it possibly on the FS UK mods page. It tells you how to do it, so that's okay. I thought it's much nicer. For example, I wouldn't want to come to a National Trust place if they had yellow grass. So nice green looks. This looks all right. Looks rather high quality grass, but it hasn't been cut for a while. Now we aren't responsible for that not being cut for a while, as this isn't something we normally do. However, like I said, the council, they stopped their mowing division. Like the way I call it a division, I don't think it's really a division. The mowing section. We don't have to. Well, they couldn't do this anymore, so we've got to do it. Hedges, though, are quite nice. Very nicely kept. Very well trimmed. For example, they take a lot of time and effort in making sure that they are as straight as possible. So it does look quite good. Go around this border once, twice maybe. It's a large area that we have to do, but shouldn't take too long with this mower. We'll leave that section there past the shed till after. And that's a vehicle that they are using as their sort of drive around maintenance sort of vehicle for here. Found that on Mod Hoster, I think it was. I don't really like using websites that aren't FS UK that don't host their own mods, as they have a tendency to not be the safest websites. For example, I use Esset Nod 32, I think it is, something like that. Smart Security, whatever it is, 9 I think it's on now. And that comes up with an alert every time that I go on one of those websites, for example. Upload.as, I think that's one. There's some mods on there. It just comes up with a little thing saying we've blocked their IP address from accessing your machine. So that's quite promising, that. That's generally why I don't use other websites apart from FS UK. So I really trust FS UK. Right. Not much left to do on this top part. I must have done about half, maybe. We've got to go around the edges on the stand-on, as this can't get as close to the edges as we'd like. The little bits that we miss, we will have to go back and do, as they want this a rather professional job. Once it's cut, it shouldn't be too long till we have to come back again and give it a little trim. As I can imagine that this will grow rather quickly. I believe that we can get a sprayer as well, a lawn sprayer. Now, if I did purchase that, I would tow it behind either the quad bike, or we would get one of these machines that like they've got. I was driving around in that earlier today, just looking at what equipment we would need for this job. It's quite nice handling, apart from the collisions and that, which go slightly messed up when you just, yeah, try to attach anything when something's on the back. It is a nice vehicle. Decent speed as well, nothing too nippy, but it will do for what we need. For example, when we're doing Stonehenge and that, I could tow a trailer up with that so we don't compact the ground anymore and damage anything. So that'd be ideal for that, I think. Sitting rather far forward, isn't he, on there? Alright, I think we're going to have to do this twice. We can see though, hopefully we don't. Although actually, yeah, probably will do. For example, here it gets a lot wider. I do like this grass texture. If I can remember, I will put a link in the description to the new cut grass texture. As personally, like I said at the start, I'm not a huge fan of that yellow. Doesn't look the nicest. In real life, it's not that yellow as well when you cut the grass. It is green like this. And nice grass as well. If that went yellow, I'd be a bit worried. Yeah, that's a job for the stand on. Maybe not that. Yeah, it is actually. So I've done this top section, now just this main area to do. Now the landscaper's entrance, because we do the grass here, it said that we can come anytime and have a look around. For example, we will probably get employed to take care of the flowers at some point, maybe, if there's anything that we need to do there. Make a new garden, or even a path that goes around here. I wouldn't be surprised if we have to do something like that. We have the equipment though. I mean, that T4, I was rather looking forward to using that. But at a place like this, it isn't really suitable. That's why I chose this mower instead, as this seems to be a bit better. It'd be nice if you could sort of change the cutting depth as well. For example, there are three states to the grass on the farming sim. So you've got fully grown like this, cut, which is this cut texture, and then like growing. Well, there might be two growing states actually. I think there's only three states actually, though. So yeah, it'd be nice if you could just cut down to the growing height. That'd be quite interesting to see. So I would use that, for example, here. I'd put limes in the grass, because it is a National Trust property. So on every National Trust place I've been to, or English Heritage, just generally nice places that you go to, they've had stripes in the grass. And it adds a professional look to it as well. So we could add that as an extra option and get paid for it. Now, we are on a contract for this actually, so every time that the grass gets to this length, we have to come and cut it. We get paid every time we cut it, so instead of just every time that it comes straight away tall when we cut it, we will leave it for a bit and then cut it, just because we don't want to rip them out of a load of money. Although it would be good for the company, this company isn't about that. This company is about providing quality landscaping services at a reasonable price to large customers like the National Trust and the local council. I think that's as big as you can get, really. When you're working for the council, it's a rather good job. They have an okay budget to deal with, so you know that you'll get paid a decent amount. Stick this in cruise control, I think. Nobody here today, is it? It's only 8 o'clock. We will be cutting it rather early every time that we do come here, though, just because there's no people about. Even though we still have to use that vehicle, that's just for health and safety purposes, again. but yeah. I believe it opens at 9, so we've got 54 minutes left to cut this whole property, which should be okay. This might be a half an hour episode, or might be a two-part episode, possibly. Now this mower doesn't leave traces of which direction it was the grass was cut in, so it doesn't matter that we are sort of going around in the circles and spirals that we are. If it did, for example, put stripes in it, we wouldn't be doing this. We would be doing the stripes. But this gets the grass cut quicker, more efficiently and effectively. It's nice that they've got the benches there. And this path as well. Something we're going to have to watch out for, because it does change heights at different places. For example there, I'm going to have to go around the top and then load them onto the trailer, just because of where it is. Getting this cut rather quickly. I would say that this is a rather large family home. A very big one at that. I can imagine that at one time, before the National Trust took ownership, this would have been one house up here. That would have been another one. But that is the sort of more famous one. Some famous people live there, I can imagine. As you see there, they got the swings. We might get employed to put in a form of sand pit at some point, maybe. That'd be quite good. Or at least prepare the ground, as we offer those services. So it'd be ploughing and cultivating that we do. And that would be on this grass section here, somewhere. Overall, it's a very nice area to work in. For example, I prefer doing this large-scale work to the little property work, which I've yet to do. Go for a drive down later and have a look at what state the grass is in those properties, as I can imagine we have to do that at some point. Not really looking forward to it, as the small scale work like that isn't the best, as I've got to use smaller mowers and that. But we get paid for it by the council. They've got a large budget, as I said earlier. So it's okay. Eight 20? No, that's going too fast. Why is the time going like that? That's not meant to be going that quick. Two, three main sections to do, but down there they're not too fussed if we can't do that. But the reason why I've done this first is because if it gets to 9 o'clock and people start coming in, then we'll not as much to do here. How's that not cutting? There we go. So the way that they've got this set out is you come and you park your car, and then you have to walk through that house and pay for your entrance and stuff. So it's a rather good setup they've got. Don't get any unwanted visitors. A nice border of the hedges. And at some point I might be getting employed by these people to put in a form of border around the hedges and that, around just the outside. Just so you can sort of keep an eye on things a bit better, and give the hedges a bit more nutrients and that, because all this grass will be taking up quite a bit of nutrients and water, so they want the best for the hedges. But they do look rather nice. The flowers there as well, which run around there, not the neatest, I have to admit that. I might go back after I've recorded this, just sort them out in Giants Editor. But yes, rather nice indeed. Not much left to do on this part now. I might use a stand on just for those sections there, just as a bit of a different mower. So yeah, probably have to say it stops saying "so yeah" so often, as I can imagine I'm saying it rather a lot of times in every video. Rather annoying though. So once we've done this mower, finished with it, I think I'll load this on once I finish the rest of the mowing, just so it sort of spreads out the weight a bit better. Get this one over the axles, and the other one goes at the front of that trailer. I would have brought the other mower, but I didn't really see the point in doing that. That just meant a bigger trailer, and that Hilux cannot pull that larger trailer. It's got to be either Unimog or one of the tractors doing it. Didn't really want to bring a tractor here, just a bit intimidating for these people. I think if they see us turning up with a tractor, don't think they'll really want us back again if we did that. Well, the nice staff here as well, friendly. Got that there, did I? I did actually, that's good. So, as well, another reason for doing this part this early, because when people are playing on here, they have a tendency to lose tennis balls and shuttlecocks for badminton and stuff, so it's easier to do it when nobody's here, apart from the staff. When it gets to winter as well, we will be doing a bit of snow ploughing around here, I think. So that should be quite good. It'll be ploughing the paths here, so we'll have skid steer on that possibly. And snow blower on the front of that, I think. Snow blower is actually quite good. I believe I could probably make that work for grass windrow as well, because, not to ruin all the fun for everyone, but that is just a rake. So it spreads out how far you want the straw. I think it's straw that, the snow is. Because when you watch the snow ploughing, the first series sort of thing on that, back in January, that was a long time ago, wasn't it? That was straw, so the whole map was covered in that. Thankfully I didn't have to do that. I shouldn't have been too hard, I don't think, because in Giant's Editor I wasn't playing about with some of the different foliage layers that we can get, and I can put grass windrow down on here if I wanted to. I don't know why I would. But I can if I need to. And you can put all sorts of stuff down. And this map as well, it's got extra foliage layers. For example, I think there's like weeds, extra grass, and that's sort of like you're not as well developed grass. So worse grass than this. I don't think you can cut it. You can get wildflowers, so that's what's in the gardens over there, the wildflowers. So yeah, it's quite a nice little thing to have. We've done this garden, it's quite good. Just drive this back up onto the trailer. In fact, no, we'll have to put it in the courtyard for that house. And we'll stop recording here. So we'll get a screenshot. So thanks for watching, guys. Really hope you have enjoyed this episode on Thornton Farm. Next episode I will finish off the rest of this garden. Just so it's done. And then we can get paid for it. So that's quite good. Got a quick screenshot. There we go. So yeah, thanks for watching. Really hope you have enjoyed it. Don't forget to like, subscribe, comment, and share, as it really does help. And I'll see you next time. Goodbye.